who went to a seminary and came out of Christianity. And this person is very, very important to Indian Christianity, because the person is none other than Billy Graham's close associate, who was a key member in Billy Graham's missionary organization, who converted 50% of India and most of 80% of Africa.
What is his name?
In the 80s, Charles Templeton.
Charles Templeton. Okay.
And you must have heard of Billy Graham.
Of course, everybody
yes,
knows that.
Everybody knows him. So he was the close associate of Billy Graham. Billy Graham and him started the organization together. And somewhere along the way, Charles Templeton thought that he did not have the... He was having difficulties with reconciling what he was reading in the Bible, like the creation story and the young earth model, original sin, redemption. So he had an argument with Billy Graham. And Billy Graham said, you should not be bothering about all those things. So here I see hypocrisy in one of the biggest...
Icon of
Christianity,
right.
More so Indian Christianity.
Yes.
So he's such a hypocrite, he goes ahead and says, Charles, you should not be questioning all these things. I may have doubts, but that's besides the point. But here I am, I'm a Christian, I will live like a Christian and die like a Christian. I may have questions, but I'm not going to bring
So what happened to Templeton?
Templeton said, okay, maybe I'm missing something that Billy is seeing. So he takes himself to a seminary, he enrolls himself in a seminary, and he says, he comes out. And quitting Christianity.
When was that?
60s.
Okay.
60s.
Okay. So that's an interesting person to study.
Yes. Charles Templeton.
So Charles Templeton is an interesting person in this to study and tell his story.
Yes.
So did you read about him?
Yes.
And that also confirmed your own journey.
Yes. And there are several other ex-Christians, eminent ex-Christians.
Oh,
well,
if you search ex-Christian, you'll get a huge number of...
But most eminent, like 20 years preacher Dan Barker, John Loftus. Mm. So these are preachers who wrote most of these songs. Dan Barker wrote most of the songs that Christians in India sing today in their worship places. So he's an ex-Christian, openly declared ex-Christian, fighting very hard now against conversions.
So, okay, we'll come to this when we talk about